Hey you, and welcome to my channel. My name is Tina and my aim is to improve your drawings just like others have done for me when I just started out. Recently I enjoyed drawing these smaller paintings where I only use limited supplies. I use a full set of Carbotello pastel pencils by Stabilo and I use 5 pan pastels. Now the colors that I'm using for my pan pastels are the 3 primary colors, red, yellow and blue, and I'm also using white and black to play with the values. For this piece, this cute little otter, I didn't use pan pastel for the edges, simply because it's too small to be convenient to work with. It doesn't take a lot of pencil to get the job done. And I'm also just going for a green blurry background where I add in some bokeh. The first bokeh I drew in were green, but I decided to make it a little bit more interesting by doing the next ones with a light blue. For the other itself, I am going to build my underlayer with the pan pastels. You can actually follow along on the right side and see the colors that I mixed before putting it onto my pastel matte paper. I want to mix some brown tones, so I'm going to start off with red and then I'll add in blue. Keep in mind that I don't exaggerate with the blue here. This way it has a purpley brown tone to it. I use this to build the ears and around the nose. For the right ear, I wanted it a little bit darker, so I just added in some black to achieve a darker value. Now for the lighter areas, I can just mix in some red and I have a lighter value with a slightly more orange tone. The more I add in red, the warmer the color also becomes. And I also use white and black to play with the value some more. Now the color mixing is just on some printer paper, so nothing fancy here. Being able to do this is one of the biggest advantages of pan pastel. No need to buy every color. With the primary colors and some black and white, you can pretty much mix every single color that you want to, after some practice at least. If you like this tutorial so far, hit that subscribe button right now. I genuinely appreciate it when you show me this kind of support, and while you're at it, why not give this video a like as well. Now moving over to the section where I use my pencils. I'll start over with the ear with some browns, but I'll mix in an ochre, I think, which is quite a bright color on my underlayer. You'll notice that when you push this into your paper, you're also muting it back down a bit. For the most part, I'll be using one of my darker browns. With animals, it's always going to be the same, but you really need to pay attention to the curve of the fur and the length. Especially when working on the face of an animal. There will be quite a lot of direction changes for the fur here, since fur follows the shape and curve of the head. On the bridge of the nose, for example, the closer you get to the nose, the shorter the fur tends to be. If you can master this, then you're already one step closer to drawing beautiful, realistic pieces. When it came to the face, I just kept the center of the otter a little bit darker, as well as the top of the head. This way it has a little bit more contrast with the cheeks, giving it more depth. Next up, I wanted the fur to have some shine to it, so to achieve this, I'll add in some light peach. You could also go for ivory, but light peach is a little bit warmer. I also wanted to give my piece some more depth, so I added some bolder colors in the middle. Some blue, purple and burgundy. When it comes to the eye, to get in the eyelid, I use dark blue, and on top of that, I use black. Again, this just gives it a little bit more life. The eye itself is quite small, so after I fill this up with brown, I'll just add some blue to the pupil part. This gives the impression that the sky is reflected in there. To finish the eye, I'll add some gray on the inner side of that eye line for the highlight. And with that, I would say that I'm done with the eyes. I'm going to add the rest of the fur of the face now. This bottom part has a more gray tone to it, so I switched my pencils accordingly. I started out with a lighter color first and then a darker color on the right and left side where the chin is. Below the chin, I almost colored it in to get that shadow across. The nose of this small fella isn't a big deal as well. When working this small, you can't add a lot of details to some elements, for instance the nose and the eyes. The larger your drawings become, the more details you can add in. So working small can be an advantage or a disadvantage, depending on how you look at it. Now for the nose itself, I like to mix it up with small dots on top of it. A few layers in a row and in some different colors. I find that this gives a really nice representation of the grooves in the nose. Now I'll start to build the fur moving towards the body. I'm using larger strokes here since the fur should be longer here as well. I'm just darkening the mouth up and I'll add some darker brown underneath before I go over it with some more grayish tones. I'm also glazing this a little bit with green to give it some color, after which I'm going to darken it up a little bit more with dark blue and black. Now when I add these in, I'm not exaggerating with the amount, just some to make that area appear darker. I'll finish this section off by using some light blue for highlights. For the body, I wanted some warmer tones on there, so I glazed a few colors and blended this out. I'm then going to use that gray that I used before to start with the fur. Again here, it's important that you notice the direction of the fur. As you can see, the other is not facing us directly, meaning I'm keeping this in mind with the fur direction. By the way, if you are into drawing animals in a realistic way using soft pastels, I have an entire playlist dedicated to just that. So by all means, feel free to go and check it out. In the meantime, I've added a second layer of fur to give it some more depth. But I needed to give it some shade. So to achieve this, I just glazed over the bottom part with a dark brown up till where I wanted my darker area to be. I can switch to an ivory to get in a more highlighted area, and especially if I add in some black fur next to it, this makes the contrast between the two bigger. I also needed to add in some stray black hairs, so I did just that. Now I went over it with my fingers to blend it out some more because I like a softer feel to it. Of course, this is a very personal choice and you can do with this what you like. Now the footage where I darkened everything up some more is lost, so this is just straight to that. But what you still get to see is how I'll do the same, but for the lighter values. I'm using white in the grey areas and a yellow for the brown areas. The bright values on the dark side here will definitely pop. And that will be it for this drawing. Although I do have to say that this piece only came together after adding in these highlights. I also used purple and some blue to give it a little bit more depth, and then for my final touches, I just need to add in the whiskers. I hope you've enjoyed this walkthrough. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate your support as this helps to grow my channel and reach other people just like yourself. Hope to see you again next Friday, and in the meantime, have a great week.